it's me, Kezia, the world's leading female dating expert for men. I want to look a little bit at shy, introverted girls and how to deal with them. Now, I'm not a shy and introverted girl. In fact, I'm quite obnoxious and I'm a little bit of an exhibitionist, so I've been told, but I'm completely unapologetic for that. As so you should be if you're also an exhibitionist and slightly obnoxious also, but that's a different video for a different time. Now, introverted, non-responsive girls can be fairly frustrating. It can be very, very difficult to get anything out of them, and it makes it a lot harder to keep the conversation going, and therefore it makes it harder to actually escalate the interaction into anything a little bit more than chit-chat. But sometimes a girl is like this not because she's shy, it could be for different reasons. She might be bored, she might not be in the mood, she might be distracted, you might have not made any impact. I know it's very easy to blame the girl and just say that she's boring and that she hasn't got anything to say for herself, but you have to remember that this girl could have been on a lot of dates before, and you've got to look at yourself. Why are you not her priority? Why is she distracted? And the best way to do that is through your conversational skills. So firstly, you need to avoid those warped and unhealthy patterns that guys often get themselves in when they're talking to a non-responsive woman. That means that they start asking her a series of dead-end questions, and it starts becoming like an interrogation. Now, the definition of madness is doing the same thing again and again and again and expecting a different result. Obviously, asking her the 14th question of the night is not going to work. And also, girls who are introverted are not so comfortable in being interrogated. If the woman is a bit of an exhibitionist and she likes to talk about herself and is very confident, then yes, asking her a lot of questions is definitely going to get the interaction going, but not necessarily with an introverted girl. Now, I created a fantastic system called the 10 hook lead system, and I created that 4 years ago, and that's on my products page if you want to check out the DVD. It's also in my book, and my book, by the way, which is in most bookstores, is called The Noble Art of Seducing Women. You can find the 10 hook lead system and the written format in there. And this shows guys how to never run out of things to say and how to stop the conversation fizzling out, how to stop the interaction becoming too boring, how to make an impact on a woman. And one of the things that I teach is to swap questions with assumptions and cold readings, but to make sure that the assumptions and the cold readings are very, very detailed. They're almost tailor-made to the woman. So a vague assumption would be, oh, you seem like a really friendly girl, or you seem like a really adventurous girl, or an intelligent girl. That can apply to 50% of the people in the room. Therefore, it makes no impact. Therefore, you're going to just get a vague response. However, if you said, and this is just an example after talking to a girl, you said to her, you know something, I bet that you were a really, really naughty girl at school. In fact, I don't even just think you're naughty. I think like you were the girl at the back of the room who got everyone else to do all the naughty stuff and you never got caught. So you're actually quite manipulative. Putting something out there like that, that strong with that much detail, is a brilliant way to get a reaction from a girl. And it's not a bad one. This is the thing. A lot of people think, but what if I'm wrong? But the more detail that you add to an assumption, the more wrong you can afford to be. Because there's three ways that she could answer that. She's either going to say, yeah, that's totally right, you got me, and in that case, you look like a genius. Now, the second response could be, well, I was kind of like that, and then what's going to happen is she's going to give you a lot of detailed information back because you made a detailed assumption, and therefore she's giving you all this information without you asking a single question. And thirdly, she could turn around and say, no, you got it completely wrong, I'm nothing like that. And therefore, she'll start asking you, why do you think that? Why do you think that about me? When the girl says why and starts asking you questions, that's breaking the pattern, or that monotonous pattern of you just asking questions. It means that she's investing in you. If she says to you that she's not like that at all, you can be cheeky with her and say, oh no, you weren't one of those like goody-two-shoe girls, ones who are always on time. I never, ever got on with girls like that. we're never going to work. Something along those lines. So whatever her answer is, it's going to create a reaction and it's going to get her to invest in you. So it's a win-win situation. I've got literally hundreds and hundreds of different things that you can use in order to get the woman talking, based on routines, little tips, techniques, little lines that I know really do create a positive reaction from women and always get them talking. But a few just for this video is by using opinions. So swap questions with opinions. An opinion, if it's a strong opinion especially, also provokes the girl to ask you more questions. Use anecdotes. Always have at least about 10 anecdotes up your sleeve that you can share with girls, preferably anecdotes that demonstrate high value. Now my last tip is if you're on a date with a girl. So you're on a date and she's really boring, she's not speaking, you've tried everything. You've tried the 10 hook lead system and for once in the whole history of mankind it hasn't worked. And this girl is just not responding. I mean, she's just literally like this, smiling just about being polite. So what do? The best thing that you can do in a situation is say to her with a big smile on your face, you know something, I think you're a lovely girl, I'm sure you're really funny and you're very interesting, but I think tonight you're just really tired. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to drive you back home or get you a taxi home. And I want you to text me when you get there and maybe we can do this some other time. And then literally start putting on your coat and start paying for the bill. I mean, it can't be like you're just sitting there waiting for her to answer. You've got to show you, your actions have to be congruent with what you're saying. So you have to literally start getting the bill ready to go. Now, this can do a couple of things. First of all, the desired result would be that it can force her out of that complacent attitude. It can force her out of that stubborn, pig-headed attitude that she might have that evening where she's just trying to get you to work and she's making no effort. A lot of the times when guys have done this and he's showing he means business, he's not actually saying to her, what's wrong with you? Why aren't you speaking to me? Look how much I'm trying to talk to you. That's just pathetic and needy and coming from a very weak place. If you're the guy that says, look, you're a lovely girl, I'm sure you're very interesting, but you seem really tired and I think probably you just need to go to sleep and I'll give you a call next week or so. That's giving her an ultimatum without coming across like a dick. And it's going to force her to actually think, hold on a second, what's going on here? He means it. I'm going to start putting more effort in. And she'll start explaining herself, going, oh no, I'm fine now, it's okay, I just had something on my mind. And then she'll start investing in you. And that's when you say, are you sure? I don't mind, I can take you home. And she'll be like, no, it's absolutely fine. The second thing that can happen is she can actually really be tired. Like I said at the beginning, you sometimes are bored, you're sometimes not in the mood. I know that I'm definitely a very talkative person, but I've been out with guys who've just been so distracted, doesn't matter what he's done, just because I got something at work or I've had an argument with a friend that I don't want to get into. And literally, if he'd have just turned around and said, you seem tired, you seem distracted, I'm going to give you a lift home, I would have slept on it, felt a lot better, and the next day I would have remembered what a thoughtful man. But he's thoughtful without being weak or needy. He wasn't pushing me to be someone else. He wasn't nagging me. He took me home. He knew the situation. He dealt with it correctly. And I would be much, much more inclined to want to see him again than if a guy had been annoying me the whole night and expecting me to be really loud and really over-friendly with him. Now the third thing that can happen is that she could have just been a really boring person, she wasn't interested in you, you took her home, and guess what? Your dignity, you kept it intact. That's the worst case scenario. But it's a little tip that I know a guy used on me years ago, and it worked a treat. So remember, the introverted girl doesn't necessarily mean the shy girl, it can be a mood that she's in. If she is introverted, if she is slightly self-conscious, the worst thing you can do is ask her a series of questions. And don't be afraid also to match her silence sometimes. Don't overwork. If you think you've done the best you can, don't talk for 5 minutes. Look completely comfortable with your silence. Don't feel like you have to fill it up with crap and talking rubbish all the time. Match her silence sometimes. Another thing is, this is the last point I want to make, All the shy people I know, all the shy girls that I know really like hanging around with loud people, actually. You don't see two shy people together. They usually don't like it. They don't like to hang around other shy people. So if you're a shy guy and you think only a shy girl will like you, you're absolutely wrong. Shy girls much prefer loud exhibitionists. I don't know why, I'm not a shy person, but I'll ask one day my shy friends why they like to hang around with loud, comical people. They say opposites attract. So bear that in mind also. Guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you got a lot from it. And don't forget to check out my website, www.kezia-noble.com, where you can find out more about my boot camps, my 7-day pickup mastery course, my blog packed with free information, my ever-growing team of trainers and wing girls. And don't forget to subscribe to this channel, because I'm going to try and upload a video every 2 to 3 weeks from now on, and it's going to be packed with free information and advice, just like this video had. So thanks for watching, guys, and I hope to see you soon. Take care.